Jenny Burney, and I'm here liturgist this morning. Please stand if you're able and join me in the prayer. People of God, we are welcomed here by our loving Creator. God's word of grace is offered to us like a cool cup of water that is offered to parched people on the hottest day. It is ready to revive and restore us. How blessed are we? Come, let us worship. And we will be singing a new hymn this morning, which Wilbert will lead us in. And the words are in your bulletin. Sorry. Let us be in silent reflection.
One of the things ask is, what brought you to Pilgrim and what keeps you coming to Pilgrim? And, you know, the range of answers for what brought you to Pilgrim is quite wide. But frequently, the response to why do you keep coming is that I feel so welcome. I know it's okay for me to be. Probably, maybe a dozen years ago, I attended a workshop in D.C. put on by the Gallup organization, and they were focused on church growth. And one of the things we talked about was the primary reason that people come to a faith community. And actually, it isn't about the denomination the church belongs to. It isn't the preacher. It isn't the choir. It isn't the beauty of the space. The most likely reason people come and keep on coming to a church is because when they walk in the door, they see someone whom they know loves them and cares about them. And it's helpful if it's more than one person. Right. Now, that doesn't mean that the preacher and the music and the prayers and the space aren't important, right? But the most important thing is that each of you are aware of the other and help each person feel welcomed. That's pretty powerful. It's like a cool cup of water. It is so refreshing and so life-giving. Hospitality is not just something that happens in a sanctuary, right? It's what we do out on the street as well. It's how we attend to the other people who are on the street and passing by, and whether it's just making eye contact or greeting or smiling. It's how we are out on the street. Kay drove back from New Orleans. She's living in New Orleans now, our daughter Kate, and she came with two of her friends, one of whom grew up in Evanston, and they didn't know each other going to high school, although they were only a couple years apart. And the other grew up in Oak Park. They all live in New Orleans now. And the fellow who lives in Oak Park, his family is Mexican, and he intentionally went to New Orleans, moved to New Orleans, because of the welcoming nature of the culture there. It's a very diverse culture, and he feels very welcome. We were talking about, at dinner the other night, we were talking about the difference between being in New Orleans and being in Chicago. He said, yes, one of the adjustments I'm making is to realize that not everyone is going to be saying hello to me. He experiences that it's how we are out on the street, right? It's how we are with people we know outside of this congregation. It's a really important element in how we carry our faith. As Maureen was saying, giving a glass of water to Evelyn is like giving a glass of water to Jesus, which in turn is like giving a glass of water to God. It is a web. We are all connected. We are all connected to each other, and we are all connected to God. One of the ways that Pilgrim cares about how we welcome people to this place is to have a lift that actually functions.
Hallelujah.
Who would have thought? And Delina Wilkerson is working incredibly quickly with the construction crew who is moving along, and we have hopes that before long we'll actually be able to have people coming up the lift and not worrying about getting stuck in it, or not being able to get in it, or not being able to get off of it, and that would be a really wonderful thing. We're also trying to make sure that we have accessible restrooms. We do have one, but one accessible bathroom is not enough. And so work is progressing on that. And our hope is that before the end of the summer, we will be able to be even more welcoming than we care to be.
Amen.
Amen for sure. Amen for sure. Yes, thank you. And another way of being welcoming is the song that we open worship with, right? It's a different way for us to sing. It's acknowledging that a lot of different people come through here, and some even stay, and they might like to sing or pray in a different way. And so again, this name just gets repeated over and over. Delina Wilkerson has put together a lot of music, and some of you attended the Before Worship program a couple weeks ago, maybe it was last week, and we'll have several more, exposing us to a range of interesting music, and that all comes out of the work of Sacred Conversations on Race. A way for us to be more welcoming, to make sure that when someone walks in here, they go, oh, I see myself here. I feel myself here. I feel my perspective and my life experience affirmed here. And certainly that is what Pilgrim has been about and cares to be about. And so we are growing and deepening our commitment to that kind of cool cup of water. A wonderful song that engages us. And actually got a lot of us moving. I was, last Sunday, I was serving in an installation service for a friend of mine, Charlene Hill, who is now installed as a senior pastor at United Church of Hyde Park. For those of you who were here for my installation 7 years ago, Charlene is the person who preached the sermon during that installation. There were several preachers there because we had different roles. There was the one who brought the sermon, there's me who brought the charge to the congregation, and there was another pastor who brought the charge to the pastor who was being installed. And the pastor who was preaching is the pastor from the Unity, from Chicago Temple, downtown United Methodist Church down there. And he's African American. And several times during his sermon, and I want you to know, this was a very mixed group. There were lots of people from many different cultures there. And a couple times he said, I know you're pretty quiet here, but maybe I could get an amen. So we're learning. We're learning to be in the sanctuary in a different way, and I really love it. And that, when we are free, can feel like a cup of water. In 2 days, we celebrate Independence Day. In 2 days, we celebrate what's referred to as the birthday of the United States. A country that has incredibly high ideals. A country that really cares about freedom and justice and is learning painfully how to live into that. In the late 1800s, Bartoli, a French sculptor, created the statue. And there was a fundraising program that went on to raise money for the statue was a gift, but the pedestal needed to be built. And there was a fundraising program that went on, and Emma Lazarus created the poem that we're familiar with. It's part of the, which is placed at the base, inside the base of the statue. And she actually wasn't interested in participating in that program until one of her friends said, but this is a symbol. welcome to those coming to this country. Ironically, it was her poem that made it that symbol, because it was really a symbol to the Republic, to the notion of government by the people rather than government by the monarchy. And it was through her poem, which was finally installed, that, and the fact that people were in fact coming across on those ships and landing in New York. Give me your title, or your huddled masses yearning to be free. Don't give me command on refugees. Don't give me command on immigrants. Give me your title, your poor. You and I have worked to make sure that who we are as a country lives up to its commitments. You and I are called to offer a pool of blood to those who are thirsty. You and I are called to do what's right, no matter what the prevailing needs is. On this day, as we prepare to celebrate this country's birthday, let us remember who we are.